This is scientific calculator. If you want to solve the eigenvalues and eigenvectors problems, by using scientific calculator, we can calculate a square, a cube, determinant of a, adjoint a, and all those things. Reset the scientific calculator, shift 9, then I got three options here. The first one, setup data, second one, memory, initialize all, means you have to choose the third option. Here again, some options I got it. Equals to, you can press equals to button or AC button. I will press equals to symbol button here. For initialization, press AC key. Like this, you have to reset the calculator. If you want to enter matrices, choose the first button, menu setup. I got some options, first one, second, and third. Fourth option is, that is matrix symbol is there. Then you choose fourth option. Then I got some options. First of all, I will enter the matrix A. First option, mat A. Number of rows, how many rows we have to enter? Press the number 3, means three rows. Number of columns, question mark, means how many columns we have to enter? 3 columns. We got one matrix symbol notation with all elements as zeros. 3 rows, first row, second row, third row, first column, second column, third column with 9 elements. First element means here 9 elements means first row, first column element. Then when you are pressing equals to symbol, it takes 1 in place of that. First row, first column element is 1. Press just minus 2. And when you are pressing equals to symbol, it takes minus 2. Again, 3 equals to key. Next, 2 equals to. Again, 3. Like this, you enter each and every element. Minus 1 equals to. Minus 3. 1. 2. Now, geometrical interpretation of Lagrange's mean value theorem. You draw the graph of the given function y equal to f of x. Again, this is x-axis, this is y-axis, intersection of these two axes is origin O. Now, on x-axis, you have to consider two points because the function is continuous. Already in mathematical definition, we have to show that the function is continuous on closed interval a comma b. Now, on that x-axis, I am taking two points. This is a point, another point is b, then ordinate of a is f of a, ordinate of b is f of b. Means, there the point is a comma f of a, capital B is b comma f of b. Now, this is the graph of y equal to f of x. Now, it can be observed that from this graph, there is no gap between capital a comma f of a and capital b comma f of b. Between these two points, the graph of y equal to f of x is smooth curve without any break. Therefore, y equal to f of x is a continuous function between capital A and capital B. Now, there exists unique tangent line at every point between capital A and capital B by seeing the diagram. Means the function y equal to f of x satisfied conditions of the Lagrange's mean value theorem. There exists at least one element between a and b. Now in this diagram, again between a and b, I am taking c here. The ordinate of c is f of c. Therefore, capital C, this is the on the graph, capital C is the point c comma f of c. At that point, we are getting one tangent line. That tangent line is parallel to joining the points capital A and B. Joining the points capital AB. Means observe this one. The line AB, capital AB, and the tangent line at C, both are parallel lines. Means it means that f dash of C equal to f of B minus f of A by B minus A. Means both lines have the same slope. This is the geometrical interpretation of the Lagrange's mean value theorem.